Dagger2, Hilt, and Koin are dependency injection (DI) frameworks used in Android development to manage the instantiation and provision of dependencies in applications. They each have different approaches to solving the problem of DI in Kotlin and Java-based Android applications. Dagger2. Dagger2 is a fully static, compile-time DI framework that generates code at compile time. It's known for its performance and scalability, but also for its steep learning curve. Dagger2 example. When you run this code, Dagger2 will inject an instance of analytics service into main activity at runtime. The addInject constructor tells Dagger2 how to provide an instance of analytics service. Hilt. Hilt is built on top of Dagger2 and simplifies Dagger-related infrastructure by providing a standard way to incorporate Dagger dependency injection into an Android application. Hilt example. With Hilt, you don't need to manually create and maintain Dagger components. The @hilt_android_app annotation initializes Hilt, and @android_entry_point prepares the activity for injection. Koin. Koin is a lightweight DI framework that uses Kotlin's features to provide a simple way to do DI. It's known for its ease of use and concise syntax. Koin example. Koin uses a DSL for module declaration and allows you to retrieve dependencies with the inject delegate, without the need for generated code or annotations. Key differences. 1. Approach. Dagger2 uses Java annotation processing to generate the DI code at compile time. Hilt is a layer on top of Dagger2 that reduces boilerplate and simplifies Dagger's usage in Android apps. Koin is a pure Kotlin DI framework that doesn't rely on code generation but uses a DSL and reflection. 2. Performance. Dagger2 and Hilt have similar performance since Hilt is based on Dagger. They are generally more performant than Koin because they generate the DI graph at compile time. Koin may have a slight overhead at runtime due to its use of reflection and Kotlin's dynamic features. 3. Ease of use. Dagger2 has a steep learning curve and requires a lot of boilerplate code. Hilt simplifies Dagger2's complexity by providing a standardized setup. Koin is known for being easy to set up and use, with a more readable and concise syntax. 4. Community and support. Dagger2 and Hilt are widely used in the Android community and are supported by Google. Koin has a growing community and is often praised for its simplicity, especially for small to medium-sized projects. 5. Debugging. Dagger2 and Hilt's compile time code generation can make debugging easier since errors are caught at compile time. Koin's runtime resolution means that some errors will only be caught when the application is running. So it boils down to the following. Dagger2 is powerful and efficient but complex. Hilt aims to simplify Dagger2's complexity for Android development, and Koin offers a more straightforward approach with a focus on simplicity and ease of use. Choose based on the size and complexity of the project, the team's familiarity with the frameworks, and the specific requirements of the application.